Hello, my name's Carrie, and for the past couple of days, our Kenmore dishwasher has been leaving grit, grime, and a white film all over our dishes. And after doing some online research, I found that the most common explanation for this problem is that it was either hard water, how much dish detergent I'm using in the dishwasher, or that there are filters or screens plugged in the dishwasher. To me, it looks like more of a dirty screen because from what I'm seeing on the dishes, it looks like that dirty water is bypassing someplace in the dishwasher and then it's reapplying it to the dishes. So what I'm going to do is check the sump on the dishwasher and see if there are any problems there. To access the sump on the dishwasher, what I need to do first is remove the dish racks on the dishwasher, and on the upper rack there are a couple plastic clips. I need to push in on the tab, push to the inside to remove the first clip. It's the same on the second clip. Push to the inside and pivot the clip towards the inside of the rack. Once I get the clips removed, I can just pull out the upper rack and move it out of the way. Then just go ahead and remove the lower rack. Inside the dishwasher, there is a supply tube that feeds water to the upper spray arm. So to access the sump, I need to remove this first. It has two Phillips head screws. So I'll remove the first screw. The second screw is located on the top of the dishwasher. I need to remove it also. Next, I need to remove the lower spray arm, so I'll grasp this plastic nut, twist counterclockwise with the spray arm while holding the nut firm. Once it's loose, I'll pull the spray arm up and out. Next, I will remove the water supply tube by lifting up on the tab, pulling the supply tube out. You want to be careful here that you don't break the tab. Remove the upper assembly of the water supply tube, then grasp, twist clockwise until the tabs line up with the holes, and lift the rest of the water supply tube up and out. Next, there are four Torx head screws that I need to remove so that I can access the sump. These are T20 size Torx head screws. Once I get the screws removed, I can go ahead and pull the center piece out of the cover that goes on the sump. Notice that it has a plastic washer on top. You want to make sure that you don't lose that. Then I can go ahead and pull the screen and the center piece that covers the sump up and out. Okay, this is what the sump looks like. What I'm doing here is taking out the screw for the chopper blade cover. It's a Torx head T15 size. now that I have the screw out, what I'm going to do is just feel around in the sump and see if I can come up with any pieces of debris. And there's some glass that's sitting in the sump. Looks like a chicken bone. And more chicken bones. Once that's done, I need to get the cover off the chopper blade. This is a little tricky. You need to pull to the right firmly to get the cover off. And the cover's also got quite a bit of gunk on it. Looks like another chicken bone. So I'm going to go ahead and clean the cover up in the sink. And this is the most important part. On the right side of the sump, there is a depression that goes down against a little rubber check valve. And if there's any debris against that, it could be causing my problem. So what I'm doing is running my finger down the right side of the edge and checking for debris against that rubber check valve. And as you can see, I did get some trash out of that depression. Next, I'll go ahead and pull out the rubber check valve. This is what it looks like. And with the check valve out, I will go ahead and fill in the depression right there and see if there's any more trash that could rest against the rubber check valve. Once I'm certain that there is no more trash in the depression that sits next to the rubber check valve, I will take the rubber check valve. The circular part goes down first, push it into place, then I will take the cover that I've cleaned up to the chopper, push it back into place, then take the number 15 Torx head screw and reinstall it. Then I'll take the center cover to the sump, line up the screw holes. And then reinstall the four Torx head screws. Remember, these are number 20 size. Next, I will push back in the center piece, making sure that the plastic washer is still in place. Then I will take the lower part of the water supply tube, line up the notches with the tabs, push counterclockwise until it lines up. Take the rest of the water supply tube, push it in the opening until the tab goes over the little clip like that. Next, I'll take the lower spray arm, hold the nut in place, and twist clockwise until it tightens on the nut. Then I'll give it a good spin to make sure it spins freely. And next I will take the two screws and reinstall them into the water supply tube. Next, I will slide in the lower dish rack, line up the rollers in the upper dish rack, and reinstall the clips. Okay, moment of truth time. What I've done is run the dishwasher through a cycle, so let's take a look at the dishes and see what happened. The plates look clean. The glasses don't show any grit, grime, or film on them, so that's a good sign. And finally, the black spoon. This is what I was really curious about. When the dishwasher wasn't working right, the black utensils had a gross looking white film all over them. And as you can see here, the black spoon looks really good. So I think I've cured the problem by cleaning the debris out of the sump. So that completes this video on do-it-yourself dishwasher maintenance. If you would like to see more of my videos, please visit my YouTube channel, Icekeeper1.